Okay, part 13. Part 13 continues where do we go from here? Okay. You can cross the offspring from each mating. After that, you can place this offspring back under or over the original cocks and hens. If if you want to, but keep the relationship as far apart as possible. What you are trying to do is to establish desirable characteristic, not concentration of blood. If you breed to a desirable characteristic often enough, you will establish it very securely in time, irrespective of the blood relationships of the parents. Keeping the blood relationship as far apart as possible become increasingly difficult, which is succeeding generation for none of us as many outstanding individuals as we would wish, but keep looking and trying and testing. You may come across one occasionally in an event test and prove it in every mating and generation before proceeding to the next. Take nothing for granted. Prove every step as you go along. You undoubtedly will find that some combination will be strong in certain respect but not so good in others. Be careful not to mate foul where both parents have the same weakness or lack of ability that could cause real trouble. The desirable combination in strength to strength, however, weakness is one characteristic. May be mated to strength in that same characteristic and the weakness be improved. All of you have been in the game for any length of time, have witnessed the spectacle of the hot shot of a few years suddenly passing out of the picture and never regaining his former stature. As old Elmer said, all the taps go down and go down fast. The usual explanation is, he lost his good old foul, but how did he lose them? Were they stolen? Did his chicken house burn down? The chances are 10 to 1 that he lost them through poultry breeding practices, possibly breeding to old foul after they had passed their prime, or by endeavoring to obtain purity through to close inbreeding, you can lose them in a hurry through either of these time-honored practices. Okay. Chapter 9. Rearing and environment. No matter how excellent your brood power, breeding system, and selection ability, you are not going to go anywhere unless your rearing facilities are favorable. And deficiency in this respect can completely destroy your entire breeding program. Accordingly, a brief word on the important subject is deemed essential. High on the list of necessary facilities is an adequate amount of good pre-range for the size of your growing stock, with plenty of nourishing green grass. In my experience, proper grass is the most essential feed in the world for the proper growing of young stock. It is of greater value than all the other feeds combined. In fact, I know of many instances where the finest feed in existence were completely unable to overcome the deficiency is caused by lack of proper grass. Please note the term proper grass. Not all grasses are alike. Some are more nourishing than others, a lot more nourishing. The same grasses will not grow in all soils or in all parts of the country. Accordingly, I would suggest that you can get in touch with your State Farm Affairs or State University. Tell them your problem and ask them recommend the nutritional grass mixtures of their particular locally. This is from sa America po ito. Don't hesitate to call upon them. Through your tax dollars, you are praying for this environment services, so you don't properly should to cooperate. Now, here is another point. The quality of your soil has a lot to do with the quality of the grass you grow. Possibly, your range is too large that you find it impractical or too expensive to fertilize all of it as intensively as you should. This applies especially to the use of compost as a part of your fertilizing program all night. Then set aside a certain arena, even if it's only a 50 feet square, or fertilize the daylights out of it. By all means, build up a compost heap maybe in the lawn clippings, and when it arrives, work in the thick. I would rather have a good compost heap and plenty of cow manure than all the commercial fertilizer even made. At the chicken dropping from your hen house to it also, then notice the quality of grass on your 50 foot plot and how the chicken will go for it. Of course, the larger the plot, the better. The chicken will devour every blade before touching the other grasses elsewhere. I have an interesting example of this tree at home, of this here at home. We have some 75 years old currant bushes which we keep going. Every year they get a heavy shot of chicken mature, compost cow mature, etc., which is marked into the ground around them. Naturally, the grass near them grows like 600 to every day. When my dog is let out of his kennel, he makes straight for those currant bushes and take a few nibbles of the grasses. There won't touch a blade of grass in any place. Too bad when humans do not know as much about nutrition in the soil as animals and birds. Among the line of feeding, here is a suggestion which you should find helpful. Use a lot of soaked sour oats in your grain mixture for all fowl from 8 weeks as long as they live. The proportion of such oats will vary according to temperature, from 40% in hot weather to 10% in zero weather. Get a couple of heavy duty plastic ash cans. The idea of having two is to have the oats soaking and souring in one should you are feeding from the other. Put in a sufficient quantity of racehorse oats in each can to last you for 3 or 4 days. Cover with water and keep it covered with water. Stir occasionally with an old broomstick, keep right out in the sun. Mix the poor sourdough into your dry grain mix with a garden trowel just before feeding, and use the trowel for measuring the amount you give to each bird. Be sure to keep the stuff on your hands and clothes of your wife would not let you come into the house. Real smelly, but these sour oats are the next best thing to green grass. Another practice which I find beneficial is the worm of fall once every month. The year around, put some commercial worm medicine in the drink. in water to 48 hours, followed this by putting some black strap molasses in the drinking water for the next 48 hours. It is wonderful tonic and laxative cheap. To don't make it too strong or the fowl will gnaw or drink it. Well, this is supposed to be discussion on breeding, not on feeding and care, but I have included those suggestions here because the best breeding practices can amount for nothing if proper care, environment, and feeding are not observed. Okay, finish.